So let's kind of just quickly recap. We used to teach children to start businesses. That used to be the default career choice. Now, we try to get our children to avoid it. You're here in a business capacity where you want to get something done. If those two match in any way, we can get something done. If they don't match, we can't.
We know that Josh does this and trains people around the world in business. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Josh Tully. Josh.
So let me tell you a little bit about what I do when I challenge beliefs professionally. The first belief I challenge is this belief that employment is the way to go. That's not how things used to work. Prior to 1903, most people weren't employed at all. They were self-employed. But we've become so disenfranchised with the system that we don't want to get involved at all. So you need to find ways to associate with people of like mind, right? Isn't it sad in America when an employee is afraid to have a dream because of the retaliation of the employer, even though the employer did the same thing that he wanted to do? For a long time, there was no country on the planet that beat us in entrepreneurship. Politically speaking, the argument's constantly about which side can create the jobs, and the answer is neither of them.
You're talking about the why, and you know, why are you in business?
Are they more like me, less like me?
Can you describe the difference or the different techniques and how you can reach out like that? Like, what's most effective?
If you don't know what your competition's doing, how they're doing it, who they're hiring, where they're expanding, where they're shrinking, where their debt is, if you don't know these things, you are killing yourself moving forward past you because you're not setting the foundation. So when small business owners say, well, I can't succeed because of the economy, what does that mean? Nothing stops the growth of an economy. Nothing, except for the people in it. So don't take fear as something that stops you. It's not that we delude ourselves to the idea of fear. We have to change our approach to it. Since we're not here for the money, yet the money is going to empower us to do whatever we want to do, whether it's time with family, vindication, restoration of the republic, whatever it is. You have to look at business as a means to whatever your why was. Why do I have the audacity or ignorance? It's one of the two. To think that my customers are gonna respond to something that I would avoid. When I tell a room of business owners these typical sales techniques, they all start laughing. And my response is, don't laugh, because this is exactly what you're counting on to grow your business. Vast majority, they all start their business at the wrong spot in an industry. You have to work in reality, because that's what's gonna pay the bills at the end of the day. If we know the open trend is declining, as a new business, why would you want to get involved in an industry, in a marketing venue that's going down? Failure in business has killed people. It has killed thousands of people. We wonder why there's no middle class, right? They're telling us the middle class is ending. That's because no financial trend lasts more than three generations. How do we keep score in business? Bottom line, money.
Hi, my name is Josh Tully. I'm the founder of Fix Your Franchise. I'm also a nationally syndicated radio talk show host. This is one of the top 100 business trainers in the world and an author. I wanted to take a moment, though, to address you directly. I know where you are. I really do. I've been in your shoes. I've helped business owners just like you. A lot of people say, Josh, why fix your franchise? Well, first let me say it's not just for your traditional franchise owner. It's for franchise owners, it's for the new form of franchise ownership, it's for dealers, it's for distributors, and yes, it's even for you network marketing guys and gals out there. We love you too. But the reason for this course is because I know where you are. I know you're driving to work thinking, oh man, is this the day we break through the ceiling? And I know the drive you have back home thinking, oh man, how do I tell my spouse that today wasn't that day? See, the problem is, we're under the illusion that franchises, distributorships, dealers, and MLMs are all successful. Well, Josh, it says there's only a 5% failure rate. Well, let me tell you a little secret about that 5% failure rate that they always tout when they're trying to sell you a franchise. It's not entirely true. It's not entirely a lie either. But when you dig into that number, what you find is that only 5% of franchise-issued loans by the SBA enter default. Well, what is that? What is that? 5% of SBA loans issued to a franchise that enter a default qualifies as failure? Well, there's a huge gap between failure and success. I'm talking to the people in this gap. The people who aren't where they need to be, but you're financially responsible enough to pay off your loan. You don't know the number of franchise owners that I've talked to, many from large parent companies that you would recognize, that said, Josh, I've been a business owner for 20 years. My business isn't working, but I'm not going to default on the loan. Or, Josh, I was lucky enough to be successful in other endeavors, so I'm not going to default on my loan, but I'm not successful. Or the number of people who have to work a second job. See, that's the stat that they don't tell you. 30% of all small businesses in this country require a secondary source of income in order to stay open. So you might be a franchise owner, a dealer, distributor, a network marketer who has another job or a spouse that's funding your franchise. Or you're borrowing money just to pay the money that you already borrowed. See, that's the truth behind franchising. That's the truth behind dealerships, distributorships, and network marketing. And that's why I invented this course. I invented this course also because I was sick and tired of crap. I was sick of the crap that's out there in terms of success training. Yes, I've been to those seminars too. They get you fired up for about 2 to 3 days, and then they kick you out. You go home, you think, all I got to do is work my numbers, build my team, rah! And you don't go anywhere. A week later, you're thinking, man, that did me absolutely no good. I spent $5, $10, $20,000 on a rah-rah rally, and my business hasn't changed. I was sick and tired of seeing that. I was sick and tired of getting phone calls from people on the show saying, Josh, I own a business, I own a franchise, I own a dealership, I own a distributorship. I'm in a network multi-level marketing company, and I just can't seem to get it to work. That's who this is for. This is for the 83% of you. 8 out of 10 people who view this video need this course. I mean, for goodness sakes, how many of these training systems consist of 10 days of training with a parent company? What is that? What is that? You would train an employee longer than a parent company trains a business owner? Really? And then we say that that's significant and substantial training? And then the follow-up training is newsletters, websites, and maybe once in a while we do an event? Which is really just to pitch you more of the system? What about real success? So this is what we've done. We've taken a course that I used to teach over a 10-week period. We've crammed it into 2 powerful days. I know you might be thinking, well, Josh, the parent company trained me for 3 days of virtual training over on an online course, so I'm good, man. How am I going to get more out of 2 days? And I'll tell you, because we took that 10 days of training, and instead of filling it up with a half hour of music to make you feel good or hug your neighbor or tell me why you can walk on fire or some other BS, it's actual practical tools you can take back with you. This is 10 weeks of training in 2 days. We also priced it at a price point where you can't afford not to go. And I know my English teacher might not like that double negative sentence, but it's true. You cannot afford not to go to this event. Yes, $24.99. And no, not $24.99. $24.99. Now, if you compare that to a good computer, if you compare that to signage for your business or business cards or even a part-time employee, for goodness sakes, it's well worth it. But I want you to think of this. How expensive is failure? Really, how expensive is it to fail? Like I said, 8 out of 10 of you need to attend this event. Do the right thing. Not for me, for you. It's your future. It's your franchise. It's your business. I am sick and tired of watching business in the Western world die on the roadside because we don't know what we're doing. I'm sick and tired of people telling me, well, the economy is terrible, when we, the business owners of the world, really control the destiny of this economy. Bottom line is this. I need to see you in the next class.